Welcome to Printful's Design Series. In this episode, I'll show you a simple way to add depth to your illustration with a layer mask and basic brush settings. I have my artwork opened up in Photoshop where all the elements are placed on separate layers. We feature this design in our Design Trends video, so if you haven't yet seen it, make sure to check it out after this video. I'll start by going to the Layers panel, selecting the layer with the strawberry, and creating a copy of it by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Next, I'll right-click on the created copy and select Blending Options. A new window will open up where I'll click on the Color Overlay button. Here, I can choose which color I want to fill the element I've copied. This will also be the main color for our grain effect. I'll choose black for now and press OK. With my copied layer now selected, I'll create a layer mask. To do this, I'll head over to Layer, Layer Mask, and press Hide All. The way layer masks work is the area of the layer mask that has a solid white color will remain visible or opaque, while the area filled with black will be invisible. As you can see on the layer mask thumbnail, the area I've selected is filled with black and the duplicate is currently invisible. Now I'll select the brush tool and in the settings panel, I'll pick a soft round brush. Next, under mode, I'll select dissolve from the drop-down menu and set the brush opacity to 30%. You can see that our brush color is set to white. So now when we do a brush stroke on the very edge of the image, we can see the grain. So now I'm just revealing parts of the duplicated image that are filled with black. You can play around with the brush size and opacity to get the right amount of grain for your design. Now I'll do exactly the same with the top part of the strawberry. If at some point you want the grain effect to have a different color, under your duplicated layers, double-click on the color overlay and choose the color you want. Easy as that. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have any questions or suggestions for a new design series episode, let us know in the comments. See you next time!